I'm Kimberly Kay with your entertainment report from MidHudsonNews.com. Thank you to my sponsor, Making Faces Unisex Salon in Poughkeepsie and Fishkill. Call them today, 296-0700 or online, MakingFacesUSA.net. Well, a hero isn't enough to save Karen Rodriguez. She was voted off American Idol. The bilingual 21-year-old from New York sang for her idol live performing Mariah Carey's Hero. But it wasn't good enough for the judges to use their once-per-season save. Randy Jackson said the judges were not unanimous in their decision. Haley Reinhardt and Naima Adedapo also were in this week's bottom three. Now next week, the remaining 11 will sing Motown songs. Then Jennifer Hudson and Sugarland will perform on Thursday's elimination show. Billy Ray Cyrus is trying to save his marriage. He withdrew his divorce filing last Friday in Williamson County Court in Tennessee. His attorney and the judge signed an order withdrawing the divorce papers. It says that he and his wife of 17 years, Tish, are attempting to reconcile. Cyrus told ABC's The View that for the first time in a long time, his entire family is communicating with each other and that things are really the best they've ever been. He released a joint statement with Tish in October announcing the split. They have three children together, including pop star Miley Cyrus and two from Tish's previous marriage. Well, Matthew McConaughey can understand why it was a good idea for his character to live out of his car in The Lincoln Lawyer. I mean, maybe it's because McConaughey lives in a trailer anyway, but McConaughey says the Lincoln is a small space that you can control, and you're already on the road when you need to be the first one at court. With an AC adapter, a coffee machine, and a phone, he says you have all you'll ever need. Well, the Lincoln Lawyer opened this weekend. Bradley Cooper looks for one scene in a script that tells him he just has to take the role. And the scene in Limitless? Well, that was when his character drinks blood. Yes, Cooper says he'd never seen anyone do that before other than in a vampire movie. He thought if he could pull that off, the movie would work. So when you watch the scene, if you think it's funny, he hasn't done his job. But if he freaks you out by going that far because of the drug he took, then the scene works. Limitless opened this weekend. Will Smith is donating replacements for 30 computers that had been stolen from a high school in West Philadelphia. That's where he was born and raised. The Will and Jada Smith Family Foundation and a charity run by a friend of Will Smith are giving 29 laptops and one desktop to West Philadelphia High School. The computers are expected to be delivered by a friend who's a community activist named Charlie Mack. Smith is working and couldn't be there to deliver them himself. Two students have been charged with stealing 60 computers from the school. Well, are you still watching Survivor? Krista is the next castaway who will face Matt on Redemption Island. Christina lost her bid to stay in the game, so now it's Krista's turn. She was voted out at the tribal council as her tribe mates seek to get a little revenge on Russell's old allies. Back at his camp, Boston Rob is showing why he's one of the sneakiest players ever. He managed to switch a hidden immunity idol clue, which points back to an old idol he's already found. I hope you're following that. The fashionistas are honoring Lady Gaga. That's right, I don't know if it was the meat dress or not, but the Council of Fashion Designers of America will give Lady Gaga a Style Icon Award at its industry awards ceremony in New York on June 6th. Sarah Bareilles wrote King of Anything about people nitpicking about her music. She says it was the last song she wrote for the album of the same name after she was starting to play songs for people. She says, people can get very vocal about what they don't like and they aren't afraid to tell her. Bareilles says she knows not to take it personally, but it still sometimes hurts her feelings. She can get her revenge though. Bareilles says if she can't say it to someone's face, she puts it in a song. You know what? Everyone else puts it on Facebook, Sarah. Well, in local entertainment news, Mohawk Mountain Stage will present the Hudson Valley premiere reading of August Osage County, written by Tracy Letts. At Unison Arts and Learning Center, 68 Mountain Rest Road in New Paltz, on Friday and Saturday, March 25th and 26th. For more info, call 255-1559. Thank you to my sponsor, Making Faces Unisex Salon in Poughkeepsie and Fishkill, featuring their own line of American-made mineral makeup that I'm wearing and I love. You can check out the makeup. It's called Avis, A-V-A-S Cosmetics, aviscosmetics.net. That's your latest entertainment report. For a new update daily, log on to MidHudsonNews.com. I'm Kimberly.